In this lecture, we are going to discuss the characteristics of equilibrium constant. Very, very important. Okay, so here, which factors influences the value of equilibrium constant and which factors does not show any effect on the equilibrium constant value. Okay, so here this concept is also very, very important. So many times direct questions are asked in the examinations. Okay, so now first let us see which factors they does not show any effect or they do not influence the numerical value of equilibrium constant. Okay, so first one is initial concentrations of reactants and products. Okay, so means whatever it may be the concentration of the reactant and product. Okay, sometimes equilibrium is started only by taking reactant and sometimes by mixing both reactant and product of a particular reaction also equilibrium can be established. Okay, two things, right? So now it does not depend on the initial concentration of the reactant and product. For example, let us take H2 plus I2 gives 2HI. Okay, so this is the reaction. Suppose in case 1, we are taking 1 molar each. In second case, 2 molar each. In these two cases, K is same. Okay, so in one case we have started the reaction by taking 1 molar of H2 and 1 molar of I2. In another case we are taking 2 molar H2 and 2 molar I2, whatever it may be. In both the cases the equilibrium constant value, numerical value of equilibrium constant is same until you maintain the constant temperature. Until you maintain the same temperature, or these two experiments are doing at a same temperature, in that case whatever the concentration you are taking, there is no change in the numerical value of K. Okay, if you take 1 gram or if you take 1 crore grams, the equilibrium constant for a particular reaction at a particular temperature is fixed. Okay, next. Second one is pressure and volume of container in which this experiment is going on. Okay, so whatever it is the pressure present or whatever it is the volume of the container, suppose this reaction is carried out in 5 liter container and 10 liter container at same temperature. Okay, so in both the cases equilibrium constant value is same. Okay, so means there is no effect of pressure and volume of the container on the numerical value of K. Whatever the volume you take for a particular chemical reaction, K value is fixed until we maintain the constant temperature. Okay, next. Addition of catalyst. Okay. So sometimes if a reaction is very slow or very fast, we use catalyst to speed up the reaction or sometimes to slow the reaction also. Okay, so those are different stories. So here simply addition of catalyst for a reaction, if you add catalyst also, there is no change in the numerical value of K. With catalyst, suppose 10 units, without catalyst also equilibrium constant is 10 units for a particular reaction. Okay. And fourth one is addition of inert gas. Okay, addition of inert gas. For a particular, suppose this is the reaction system which we are discussing. Into this one, suppose you have added some inert gas, helium or neon or argon, whatever it may be. In that case also, there is no change in the K value. Okay, so this inert gas, they do not react. Inert gas means that does not react with either reactants or products. Okay, simply by the addition of this inert gas, just equilibrium position changes, not the equilibrium constant value, that we discuss in the Lee-Chatelier principle applications. Okay, so clear. So whatever the concentration of reactant and product you are taking initially, K value is same for a particular reaction. So now here we discussed different concentrations, K value is same until we maintain the same temperature. Okay, and pressure and volume also, they do not show any effect on the numerical value of K. Okay, and addition of catalyst and the addition of inert gas. So these four factors, they do not show any effect on the numerical value of equilibrium constant. Right, now, so which will influence the equilibrium constant value? Okay, so first one and very very important one here is temperature. Okay, temperature. See here, by maintaining constant temperature for a reaction, whatever the change you do, all these four types of changes, there is no change in the K value. But once, if you change the temperature, then immediately the numerical value of K changes. Okay, so this is the only experimental factor. Only experimental factor which influences equilibrium constant value. Okay, temperature. And next one is mode of writing the equation or chemical reaction. Okay, so mode of writing the equation. Okay, and for example, suppose the same reaction we can write. Okay, H2HI gives H2 plus I2, or we can write H2 plus I2 gives 2HI. Okay, so here in this case equilibrium constant is different. Suppose if the same reaction is reversed, equilibrium constant value changes. Okay, for this reaction you have calculated equilibrium constant. If the reaction is reversed, then in that case equilibrium constant value changes. Okay, so these also we discuss separately. Here only we are discussing which factors influence and which do not influence. In this next lecture we discuss Van't Hoff equation and how it shows temperature shows its effect on the K value. And these also we discuss separately in the next lecture. Here only we are discussing factors. Okay, and how they influence, that we discuss in the upcoming classes. Next, another one is stoichiometric coefficients. Stoichiometric coefficients. Okay, stoichiometric coefficients of the reaction also, they also change the equilibrium constant value. Okay, so means if a reaction is multiplied by some number or if a reaction is divided by some number, in those cases equilibrium constant value immediately changes. Okay, see here, for example, this is the reaction, we can write this one, 1 mole of HI gives half mole of H2 plus a half mole of I2. Okay, so for this reaction equilibrium constant is different. For this reaction, see, in both cases same reactant, same products, but the stoichiometric coefficients are different, right? If stoichiometric coefficients changes, then K value also changes. How they will changes, that we discuss in the next class. Okay, clear? So these factors, they do not influence the value of K, and these factors, they influence the value of K. And this is the experimental factor. See, these two are not experimental factors, theoretical factors. Okay, after calculating K for this one, simply if you reverse the reaction, we get the equilibrium constant becomes reciprocal. Okay, same here also. For this reaction, suppose you have calculated equilibrium constant. For this one, no need to calculate the equilibrium constant at that temperature. Okay, how that we can calculate, that we discuss, right? Okay, so in the next lecture we discuss a very very important one, that is a temperature effect on the equilibrium constant. Okay, and one more very very important point here is that okay, K value, okay, numerical value of K gives an idea about relative amounts of reactants and products. Okay, so the value of K gives an idea about the relative amounts of reactants and products. Okay, so that is also one of the most significant important factor about K. Okay, see here, if K value is more products are formed. If K value is less number of products are formed. Okay, so those we discuss in the applications of equilibrium constant. Okay, clear? So K value, what is the significance of K? This K value gives an idea about the relative amounts of reactants and products present in a particular reaction. Okay, thank you.